What's up, everybody? It's Angelina from Divine Hustles, and today I'm here with
Landro from LA Street Chefs.
Hey, that's what's up. And what are we doing here today? What's this going on? Our hair looks delicious.
Thank you. Uh-huh. So this is what we call our fusion rolls. It's both actually like a lumpia or egg roll. And what I'm making is chicken tinga. And what it is basically, like I said, an egg roll. We put in roasted peppers, cilantro, purple cabbage, and then we wrap it up, pan fry it, and it's just, that's pretty much it. And we also have a ropa vieja steak too.
Yummy! And how did this all start up? You falling in love with creating food, what's that?
I just loved just the both Asian and Spanish cultures. I wanted to go and do something different, bring the cultures together, and just make something different and unique for people to enjoy.
When did you start cooking? When was the very first time you found yourself in the kitchen just indulging yourself with the pans and oil and all that?
Oh man, probably when I was in my teens, but I started cooking when I was about 10 years old. I started cooking.
What was the first dish?
It was just basic stuff, like canned food, stuff that my mom taught me how to just survive on my own, you know, just simple stuff, you know, nothing complicated. Then when I got around like older, I wanted to go to school to learn. So I did get my degree in culinary, and I graduated back when 2000 and, oh my God, it was a few years back. I was 27 at the time, so it's been a while now.
What was that life like, going to culinary and then turning into a career?
It's completely different. It's something
really?
You have to do. Yeah, it's like you gotta love it. You really have to have that passion for it, because as you can see, it's not easy.
Yeah.
Especially creating something that's so different, you know, and unique. It's art.
Yeah.
It's art.
Speaking about being different and unique, what would you say outside of just being mixing Spanish and Asian food, that fusion, what makes you different from other fusion food people?
Food vendors? It's really the flavor. It's the stuff we put in it. Mm. You know, it's the flavors, the way how we prepare the food. It's just everything that goes in it is what makes it really just different, unique, that pop of flavor. You know, our churros are different. Our fries are different, you know?
Oh my God, I know. Dude, so when we walked up, I was watching him and I was like, what is that? I saw it in a cup. It was like these green
churro.
Little...
It's those right there. You can film
those.
Green. The green, yes.
Why are they green?
There, I use a leaf called pandan. And the leaf, it tastes like coconut. It's like coconut vanilla. So we cook the leaf, we extract the flavor from it, and then I mix it with the masa. So that's why it turns green. So it's literally a green leaf.
I've never heard of anything like that.
That leaf, you can find it in Thailand, mostly in Southeast Asia.
Mm. Have you ever traveled to Asia?
No, I haven't. But maybe one day, that would be the plan.
Can you see yourself expanding your food internationally?
Not internationally, no. No, just kind of maybe keeping it local. I kind of do a lot of the private catering, so people that want to try my food, they want to book me, they say, hey, you know, can you come and cook for my family? I'll definitely go out and do that. So people like the type of twist, the flavors that I do.
The fusion.
Yeah, yes. Not like your traditional type of food, just something different.
What's the difference between vending out at, let's say, catering events like this and then being on the street?
Catering is just different. I want to say in so many different aspects, because for example, like a client will tell me, hey, I want to feed 30 people. You know, can you feed 30 people? What can I get in the menu? Versus when you do street vending, it's a hit and miss. You know, you have to have that energy. You have to have that mindset to keep in mind that, hey, you know what? Today I might do good or I might do bad. You know, so it's a hit and miss sometimes, and that's just how it is when street vending.
And then what's one Asian dish that you could like, you cannot go without?
I love noodles.
Noodles.
Noodles is my thing. Like, I love noodles, and you know, anything with noodles, I'm there. So like chow mein, I'll definitely eat that, or udon noodles. So anything with noodles.
And Mexican food?
Mexican food, tacos. You can't go wrong with tacos. I love tacos, like hands down. Yeah.
And then what's the most like memorable part of your career so far, from culinary school to today?
There's a lot. To be honest with you, I constantly get people that are hitting me up, and they're like, hey, you know, can you do a party for this amount of people? You know, and they want, particularly, it's always the fusion rolls. They always want the fusion rolls, you guys, and then, you know, it's just something that they enjoy. I guess they can see the love that goes into it, the art, the craft, and all that.
Yeah, you really are an artist.
Thank you.
And then something more like sacrifice side of becoming culinary artist.
the sacrifice is just a lot, you know. You have to devote yourself in the kitchen. Like, you don't have time for friends, for family. Like, it's a long shift, you know. You don't have time to really socialize. Your closest friends is the people working in the back with the kitchen, in the kitchen with you. And that's it, you know. But this is all part of sacrifices, you know. We all gotta sacrifice.
Yeah, and that's the life of following your passion too. If you want to build that passion, you have to dedicate yourself.
Right, exactly.
Dude, and people don't really understand that. All the time you miss out, whether it be with friends or family, because we've spoken with other hustlers too, and they always said the same thing. Yo, I miss, some people even said that they miss their children being born too. Like, it's insane, but.
Yeah, you gotta sacrifice, it's true, it's true.
How do you feel about that?
It sucks, you know, but it comes with a price. Everything comes with a price. You know, you really want to put yourself out there. You really want to represent what you do. You want to follow your dreams, your passion. No one's really going to support you other than yourself. You got to believe in yourself. So, of course, it's going to cost you, you know, your social life, your drive, everything. It's going to take it all.
Dude, and how did you come across making these fusion rolls? Those are a hit, as I can tell. What made you think, oh, I want to put bell peppers or put all this stuff in there?
Well, cooking, it has to be all about balancing flavors. So that wasn't the hard part. The hard part, I think, for me was creating something that would be light but also flavorful for people. These go really good, because originally my plan was to open up a small restaurant and serve these up with any type of cocktail, because they go well with cocktail, like booze and stuff, because it's not indulging, it's not so heavy on your body, because we don't deep fry it, we pan fry, so it doesn't consume so much of the oil. So when you're eating those and you're drinking alcohol, your body doesn't feel overwhelmed. You can still enjoy your evening, your night, and it's just perfect. So we started off with that. And I just wanted something simple, just something just to get people to taste and go from there.
Wow, I never even realized how much detail goes into just
cooking,
making food. All I do is eat it, and I'm like, okay, that's bomb.
Yeah, there's a lot of detail that goes into it.
Whoa! Can you ever see yourself getting a food truck, like, at some point, or you want to go
from this? Yeah, I can see myself getting a food truck at some point.
You think that's the next step for you?
No, probably just maybe be more smarter in reference of, like,
finance?
Yes, that for sure. Money, and then managing what I can do by myself, because of course, like we talked about earlier, when you're pursuing your own passion, your dream, you can't rely on anybody other than yourself.
Yourself hiring more
As things get better? Yes, of course, absolutely. I can see myself hiring more people. Absolutely.
Dope. I was only asking because, like, transition from this to a food truck and then to your restaurant. Can you see that happening, or do you want to go from here to a restaurant then have, like, a food truck while you have a restaurant?
No, I can see myself doing from this to, like, a small shop then a food truck. Yeah, I can see that happening.
A little hole in the wall with bomb food.
Yeah,
but we need two last messages from you, okay? So the first one is going to go out to the youth.
Oh, sure. You know, anyone out there that's pursuing their career, their passion, or even if you don't know what you want to do in life, I would just suggest just do what makes you happy. You know, find out your own creativity, your own, what makes you good at, and just go from there. If people like it, then that's your calling. Just don't give up no matter how hard it gets.
And what took, actually, that's good what you said, because, like, what made you realize that you wanted to be a chef? Like, what moment in life or person you met or conversation that you had that sparked that and made you want to?
Just in reality, you know, we're all gonna be stuck working no matter what. It's gonna be the type of job you wanna do or the type of job you love to do.
Working for somebody else.
Yeah, and working for somebody else. So in this case, I'm like, if I'm gonna stick to a job, I'd rather do what I really love, which is cooking, get paid for it, and then eventually create my own
franchises and stuff. Okay.
Stuff like
and your
that,
own
yeah.
You are your own boss. That's a lifestyle that everybody must dream about.
I'm sure.
Yeah. Yes. And then your last message to hustlers out there grinding right now, following their dreams, being passionate right now.
Just don't give up. Don't give up. It's gonna get hard no matter what, and you just gotta keep going. You gotta listen to that voice in the back of your head and just be like, this is me. I can do it. I'm gonna do whatever it takes to get to it, and that's it. You know, you can do it. It just takes a lot. Takes a lot, but anybody can do it.
Yeah, just be you, go for that.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, you're ready here, folks. Be kind, support each other, keep hustling, and y'all need to come try this food. It smells bomb, it looks bomb. Check them out. Your ads and socials so they can find you.
Yeah, so check us out at LA Street Chefs, and then we also have our website up, so you can check to see what orders we have if you want to place any orders. But our Instagram is LA Street Chefs, so check us out, you guys.
Check them out, try this food, keep hustling.
Peace.